Good evening. I'm Tina Monzon Palma, coming to you live from the International Media Center in Pasay City for the closing of the APEC Economic Leaders Meeting. On our broadcast tonight, leaders of Asia-Pacific nations are responding to a world threatened by terrorism as the APEC Forum wraps up in Manila. Christian Esguerra is with me here. He has been covering the APEC meeting since Monday. Christian, you covered the formulation of the statement. Is this a strong statement condemning terrorism, unusual for APEC leaders?
Definitely, it was a strong statement, but it was not unexpected given the gravity of the attacks in Paris. Here's my story and what the APEC leaders had to say about that incident. 11 months of work for the Philippines as this year's hosts of the Asia-Pacific Economic Cooperation have ended with a promise from the economic leaders to take concrete steps to bring down trade and investment barriers across the region and make sure that no economy, big or small, is left behind. But as in meetings in the past, APEC leaders highlighted the serious threat posed by international terrorists to the region, which makes up for nearly half of the global trade. Defiant APEC leaders on Thursday issued a joint statement vowing they would not be cowed by terrorists, especially with meetings in Manila taking place in the wake of the attacks in Paris and Beirut and the bombing of a Russian airliner that killed all 224 people on board.
Reminding everyone that the world stands together in the fight against terrorism, and Canada is resolute to do its part.
APEC leaders said increased international cooperation and solidarity would help win the fight against terrorism. President Aquino led the closed-door leaders' retreat at the PICC. At the heart of this year's APEC agenda is the call for inclusive growth across the region, more concretely by helping micro, small, and medium enterprises gain better access to global trade through better financing and insurance.
Our theme for APEC 2015 has been building inclusive economies, building a better world. By balancing the discussions in APEC between the technical aspects of trade and its implications on the social and environmental challenges of growth, we have refocused our discussions towards all our people, the ones whose lives we as leaders are pledged to improve.
APEC leaders also vowed to continue working toward a free trade area of Asia Pacific, even if 12 APEC economies are also backing the Trans-Pacific Partnership being pushed by the United States. U.S. President Barack Obama's TPP is said to be intended to rival the FTAAP, which has China's support.